Hi everyone, this is Kalyan Kumar and welcome to Product Review. In this video, I'm going to be doing the unboxing and review of TaoTronics EP002 Active Noise Cancellation Earphone. Now, let's first talk about what is noise cancellation and why was it introduced in the first place. Now, noise cancellation, in fact, has been around for quite some time now. And the recent development and improvement in its technology has not only made its quality much greater than what it was, but has also expanded the application of noise cancellation. Now, noise cancellation was first introduced when, during the advent of the media players like the iPod, people had started listening to music more and more using earphones. Now, over a period of time, what was found was the hearing ability of people was getting impaired due to constant listening of music with earphones, especially with the volume high. Because generally we use these devices, we listen to music while we are in the aircraft, while we are moving in a traffic. And these are times when the ambient noise is very high. And during such times, we tend to crank up the volume higher than that is suitable for our ear. And over a prolonged use, it was found that such a thing was causing damage to the ears. So the people who manufactured this earphone and headphone decided that they had to do something about that to address this very issue. And that is when noise cancellation was launched. Now, noise cancellation is a method, it's a process by which the ambient noise or the background noise, as we call it, is decreased while you're listening to music using an earphone or a headphone. So when this sound is reduced considerably, of course, noise cancellation doesn't mean it'll make it zero. It'll reduce it to such an extent that it almost becomes negligible. And then you will be not required to increase the volume of the music or anything that you're listening to so that your ear can be protected. So this is a process by which the ambient noise gets reduced. Now, what are the various types of noise cancellation techniques that we have? To understand that, first of all, let's understand the different earphones and headphones that you have. Earphones are basically the ones that you plug into your ears, like the Apple EarPod or whatever earphones that you get along with your mobile phones. So these are the ones which plug into your ear and you listen to the music using that. The headphones are the ones which have a band running over the head and then you place the headphone on the ears. There are two types of headphones generally. One is called on-ear, the other is called over-ear. The on-ear headphones are the ones which you simply place on top of the ear, which doesn't cover the ear completely. Whereas over the ears are the headphones which have cups built into them and these cups cover the complete ear. Now, there are two types of noise cancellation. One is passive, the other is active. Passive noise cancellation is generally seen in over-the-ear headphones. These are headphones which completely cover the ear. So they physically block, they physically obstruct the sound from coming into your ear by blocking the ear completely. So as it is, when you're blocking your ear with anything, you'll automatically find a reduced noise level. So, and these are on top of that built with special sponge, special foam inside, which not only gives you comfort, but also helps in blocking any kind of sound from any of the crevices that may be left after the headphone has been put onto the ear. Now, the surface of these over-the-ear headphones are such that they reflect the sound that comes into them. So that is another way by which they reduce the noise going into the ear. So this is a physical obstruction of sound. The second part, which is the active noise cancellation, is the one which uses electronics. And all active noise cancelling headphones and earphones are the ones in which you will find some kind of a battery being used. So in the active noise cancellation technique, the ambient noise comes, and these earphones and headphones have microphones built outside them. The ambient noise goes through the microphone. The microphone then analyzes the sound and then pushes the sound into the noise cancellation processor, the audio processor. And generally most of the noise cancellation earphones and headphones, they come with a small rectangular piece of material in which the audio processor resides. So then this is pushed to the audio processor. The audio processor then generates a waveform which is opposite to that of the waveform that has come in. So the polarity is altered, it is opposite. So wherever the crest, the mountain of the audio noise that is present, you will find the valley of the generated sound. So the idea is to cancel the amplitude. Now obviously the amplitude that is created by the audio processor is exactly not equal to the amplitude of the incoming ambient noise. That's why in noise cancellation you can reduce the noise but not cancel it completely. Now this sound, this wave is then pushed through again the wire to the small speakers of your earphone or headphone. And then cumulatively the effect would be extremely reduced noise. And generally the noise level that is reduced is anywhere between 25 to 80 dB, and that too depending on the kind of frequencies, because not all frequencies are reduced by the same amount. Active noise cancelling earphones and headphones would not work much with very high frequencies, like a car horn, like somebody shrieking. So that high frequency is going to be difficult for the active noise cancellation to reduce. So remember, each peak, each frequency is reduced by different amounts, but the ultimate effect is overall you will find a reduction of close to 70 to 75% of the ambient noise, which is a great deal, because then the amount of volume of the music that you need to keep need not be very high. And once the music starts, you will virtually not hear any ambient noise at all. So the requirement for the volume of the music is generally less than 50% of the volume that you need to keep if there is no active noise cancellation, and therefore that will protect your ear. That was a little bit of introduction that I wanted to give you. So let's go ahead and do the unboxing and review of the TaoTronics TT-EP002 active noise cancellation earphone. So this is the box, as you can see, and there's not much information outside the box. You have been given this model TT-EP002, and not much. It's US, it's a US manufactured device. Active noise control earphones, that's it. They don't even have TaoTronics written anywhere. So that's it. So that's not much into the box now. So let's open it up. And so, all right. So this is the packaging that it comes with. It's very nicely and neatly packed. And so let's take this out. I think I'm going to take this entire thing out first. And as you can see, this is the wire. And I'm glad that it doesn't have a very long cable, because very long cables are going to be really, really big problem to handle and manage, especially given the fact that you're going to listen to music with a portable device like a phone or an iPod or something. And therefore, one doesn't need that kind of a long cable. And they have tactfully made a cable of a medium size. So let's take this out, and let me take this out completely, and then what I'm going to do is first let's go and check the box. So now this is empty, so let's keep it here. This is the user manual. This will tell you what each parts are and what are they supposed to do. So let's keep the manual aside for a moment. Free 18 months extended warranty, free gifts. And these are the, as you can notice, these are the silicone cases, and this is the ear knob, and so these are extra knobs for that. Let me just take this out for a moment. Unfortunately, I'll end up damaging the cover. So this is what I'm talking about. So this is what comes along, and there are I guess about five of them here. And so in case this wears off or you lose this, you can still have this being put here. So right now we don't need this. This is the charging cable. and it has a micro USB charging port that is here, and all you need to do is push this, so it goes inside like this. This is the USB type A on one side, and this is the adapter for the aircraft audio system, so it comes along with that. So all you need to do is put this jack here, and then it's ready to be used. And then it has this small pouch, and a reasonably good pouch, so you can store your headphones, your earphones in this. So now let's examine the earphone itself. And the first thing I'm going to do is put this thing in my ear and check whether I'm able to feel comfortable along with it. Yes, it's perfectly comfortable. And I don't think it's going to come off that fast. Small amount of tugging is not going to get this off. And in fact, what it has done is, it has automatically blocked a lot of sound, because these earplugs have been designed in such a way that the moment you position them near the eardrum, automatically it blocks the sound. So this is another way of passively doing it. And then we have this audio control, and the top part, the one that is near the earphone part, this is increased volume. This is increase of volume, this is decrease of volume, and this one is for play, pause, as well as receiving phone calls or cancelling phone calls. You can use using the middle button. And there is a small microphone at the back of this, the small hole as you can see at the back of this. This microphone is for letting you answer phone calls and talking to your phone conversations. So then comes this rectangular piece of material. This is, I think it is metal. Yeah, this is metallic. The rest of them, of course, are plastic to decrease the weight. This is the place where audio processor resides. And it's got two buttons here. The button on top, this is for switching on the noise cancellation. So if your battery is charged, all you need to do is flip the switch up, and you can see a yellow light coming in. Now you can listen to your music without even switching the noise cancellation. It will work just like any other ordinary earphone. And if you want, you can switch on the noise cancellation. So if your noise cancellation, if your battery is not charged, you can still listen to music without using noise cancellation. Battery is only required for noise cancellation. And then the second button here beneath this, there are two buttons, as I said, one on top and one at the bottom. Now the second button is for reducing the volume of the music without deactivating the noise cancellation. So in case there is an in-flight announcement, so what it will do is, it will reduce the active noise cancellation by half, it will reduce the music by half, and you'll be able to listen to all those announcements, and then push it back and you'll be able to listen to the music and the noise cancellation at the same volume. So that is the basic construction of this device, not much to it. And this is the TRRS adapter. It has got three rings, so it can be used with your mobile phone, or for that matter, audio recorders. You can even use this with the cameras that you have to listen to the sound capture of the cameras. So that's the basic deal with this. So what I'm going to do now is, I'm going to spend a day with this and figure out how it works, figure out how it sounds, and then I'll come back with the review. So welcome back, and I've spent an entire day with this earphone, and I must share this, that the noise cancellation is absolutely fantastic. It is very much comparable to Bose. In fact, I had a Bose headphone before this, noise cancellation headphone. But the problem with that headphone was that you could not listen to music without switching on the noise cancellation. And the reason I'm saying this is because if the battery wears off, in case you don't have an external battery, that used an external battery. And if you don't have the external battery with you, you simply will not be able to listen to any music. And unfortunately, I lost it somewhere. And that is why I wanted another noise cancellation earphone or headphone. And I decided on an earphone because headphones are very cumbersome to use. You cannot use them by lying down. And therefore, they are really heavy. Even though the Bose headphone was pretty light, but even then you have something sitting on your head which is not going to make you feel comfortable. So earphones were the best solution. And the reason I didn't go for the Bose earphone was because one of the biggest problem with these earphones, the noise cancellation earphones, is that they have an inbuilt battery. That's why you saw a charger there. The charger that was given is basically because it has an internal battery. There is no external battery that you can put. And the problem with the internal batteries, they are non-replaceable batteries. So maybe after 2 years or 2.5 years, when the battery wears off, you will simply not be able to change the battery. And if you cannot, the entire active noise cancellation becomes extremely passive because there isn't any noise cancellation that is going to happen now. And therefore, I decided not to spend that kind of an amount for Bose, because that Bose earphone was costing me somewhere around 17 to 18,000 rupees. And that is approximately around $220-$250. And this one costed me less than half. It was only 7,000 rupees. And 7,000 rupees is just over $100. So I preferred this rather than Bose, because the battery is going to wear off very soon. So please remember, if whenever you're going to buy a noise cancelling earphone, remember this, it will have an internal battery and that will wear off after some time. And then you will be able to use it like a normal earphone rather than a noise cancelling one. And using a normal earphone and then you have this rectangle thing dangling all over you, that is going to be looking very funny and very difficult to use as such. So that is one issue with using the noise cancellation earphone. The headphones rather come in two varieties. They have external batteries like the AA batteries, and there are some which come with the battery internal. I would suggest always go for the ones which use external batteries. Internal batteries are not going to be good. But the downside of using external battery is that in some of them, especially like Bose, you will not be able to hear music without those batteries. So if the batteries die off and you don't have immediately another battery to replace it with, you simply will not be able to listen to music. So what I used to do was, every time I used to use the Bose headphone, I would once I stopped using it, I would remove the battery and keep it separately, because I didn't want the battery to leak or the battery to die off. So that, of course, is a different kind of a pain that you will experience. So, but overall, the impact is that this earphone gets a thumbs up from me. It's a really very good earphone. It was able to, in fact, when I reduced the noise, when I switched on the active noise cancellation, the volume got up automatically by about 25%. So I turned down the volume of my MP3 player, in fact, my iPhone. And that way I was able to listen to the music at around 35 to 40% volume than the volume that I would generally use without noise cancellation. So that, I think, is one of the best things about this earphone. And I did make some voice calls, and the mic was able to pick up everything pretty nicely. I was able to answer calls. I could decline calls and increase or decrease the volume using the small volume controller that you have, the volume rocker that you have just below the earphone. So it worked pretty well. Of course, I have to wait and see how long it lasts, but it works very good as of the first day of testing. And as I said in the beginning, newer applications have come up for the noise cancellation technology. Apart from decreasing the ambient noise for your earphone or headphone, another place where it can be used, or it is being used, is in cars. In cars, when you sit inside a car, you do hear engine noise, especially if it's a diesel car. And on top of that, you will also hear some traffic noise. So what car manufacturers are doing is that, apart from making sure that the engine noise is reduced by the material of the bonnet, by the material of the internal cabin, they've also put some small microphones around the bonnet, which picks up the engine sound. It also picks up some traffic sound. And then the speaker inside generates a waveform of opposite polarity, thereby completely diminishing the engine noise, and you will hardly feel any engine noise. In fact, I sat in one of those cars. It's an Indian car called Endeavor. It's by Ford, and this one has the noise cancellation inside the cabin, and I could not hear the engine sound at all. It was so low. The second place where noise cancellation are being used are in studios. Same thing as in cars, in studios also you don't want the ambient noise to come in. So what they have done is that they have put small speakers outside the studio which picks up the ambient noise, and internally it provides, the speakers are there, they give the waveform of the opposite polarity, thereby again decreasing the external ambient sound. And the third situation where I found it being used is the reverse of the second. That means if you don't want the noise from inside to go outside, and this happens sometimes in homes, so they don't want the internal sound to go outside, so what they do is they create this active noise cancellation inside by embedding small microphones throughout the house and small hidden speakers outside the house which will cancel all these sounds, and you will not be able to hear anything outside. So the concept of soundproofing has completely changed. Earlier the soundproofing was only made up of having a particular type of material, but now it's gone from material to technology. So that is the end of this review. So now what I'm going to do is, since I've been able to hear this noise cancellation and you have so far not been able to hear this, so I'm going to now demonstrate for you a sound clip which I recorded while I was traveling today to my office. And in this you will find that I'm inside the car, and I'm going to show you how I experienced the noise cancellation and what was the difference between no noise cancellation and noise cancellation. And then I opened the window of the car as it was moving. So now the ambient sound increased, and then again I'm going to show you how the sound changed from noise cancellation to normal, normal to noise cancellation with without music. So you'll find all of that in the clip that follows now. So that's the end of this video from my side. This is Kalyan Kumar signing off. Have a great day. Goodbye, and thank you for watching. If you find the videos of this channel interesting and useful, and you haven't subscribed to this channel, then go ahead and hit the subscribe button just below the video. The moment you're subscribed, you'll find a bell icon. Click this, and it will give you a notification which says "Send me all notifications for this channel." This means the moment any video is posted in this channel, you'll receive a notification by mail. Just check this box. Hit save. Now you're subscribed to this channel, and now you will also receive notifications from this channel. If you like this particular video, make sure that you hit the thumbs up button.